All right, Jalen, who got the better end of this deal?
Robert, actually, I think it was a win-win for a couple of reasons. If you're the Denver Nuggets, you understand that winning 50 games last year did not get you into the playoffs. Because playing in the Western Conference, all of the great teams have an all-star guard and an all-star big man. So that means you need a guard defensively and offensively as well as a big. And they didn't necessarily have that with Iverson, and the pieces didn't fit as George Karl mentioned. Now you can get J.R. Smith into the lineup, Galiza into the lineup, make Carmelo Anthony the go-to player. But the health of their bigs are ultimately going to determine how far they go with Kenyon Martin in the net.
Did the Nuggets give the Carmelo AI combination enough time? Were they ever going to get to the top of the Western Conference?
Well, I think it was a short period of time that they had to work together and make it happen anyway. Everybody knew that AI's contract was up after this season. But again, I have to point back to the injuries. They did make it to the playoffs 1 or 2 years, but they ran into the San Antonio Spurs.
Right.
And we all know what happens when you run into the San Antonio Spurs. They're a team that can go on and win the championship. But style-wise, probably not, because ultimately, if you notice, teams are getting away from the run-first mentality. Yes, playing in Denver, as I did for 2 years, you want to take advantage of the altitude, but ultimately, Chauncey Billups gives you more conventional guard that's going to set people up, be a pass-first point guard, play defense, and he made his name Mr. Big Shot for a reason, being Finals MVP.
You know, just listening to some of the post-game comments that Rasheed Wallace and some of the other Piston veterans had about this deal, you know, they're still in shock about it, and they hate losing Chauncey Billups. How long do you think it's going to take for AI to mesh with that already set nucleus there in Piston?
And they should be. The fans are going to be. The coaching staff is going to be. Joe Dumars even mentioned it. The bottom line is, when you have a success with a player or a success with a team, those are the situations that you remember the most. So going to 6 straight Eastern Conference Finals, 2 NBA Finals, and winning a championship, Chauncey Billups cemented himself into the Detroit community and inside that locker room. Allen Iverson, however, being a Hall of Fame performer, will earn the respect from his teammates because he's a game changer, and they know he's coming there to try to help this team get over the top.
With AI coming to Detroit, are the Pistons now the favorite of the Eastern Conference?
Boston's still the favorite in the East, but however, look at how the Pistons lost the last couple of seasons. To the Miami Heat, led by Jason Williams. To the Cleveland Cavaliers, led by Booby Gibson. And last year, obviously, to the Boston Celtics at point guard, Rondo. Allen Iverson, the kind of guy you can get in a 7-game series, and he could completely take over a series. Gives Detroit an opportunity to rebuild, get under the salary cap when his money comes off, when Rasheed Wallace money comes off, when Antonio McDyess money comes off, but yet still puts them in a position to compete for an Eastern Conference crown.
Money, one of the subplots in the Stephon Marbury New York Knicks saga as we focus on another point guard. What do you make of what's going on between Steph and the New York Knicks?
Well, last season, when Stephon Marbury and Isaiah Thomas got into their situation in Phoenix and he was sent home or allegedly sent home, Stephon Marbury was actually pled guilty by public assumption and by the media. Mm-hmm. Now, actually, he gets a chance to be the victim because he's healthy, he's there ready to play, but the business of basketball, not the game itself, is stopping him from playing. If you didn't want Stephon Marbury on the team, don't bring him to camp. We all know you're trying to make a new change with Donnie Walsh up top, with Mike D'Antoni and the coaching staff, and that's fine. Let Stephon Marbury go during the summer. To bring him into the season is asking for trouble. The same with Jamal Tinsley and the Indiana Pacers. There's another player, because of contract situation, because of behavior, you don't want him on the team, but yet on the 1st and 15th, he still goes collect a check like the other 15 guys. It's not fair to the league. It's not fair to the fans. I would like to see these situations get resolved ASAP.
Well, Steph has mentioned, hey, I'm going to get my money. I'm not doing any sort of negotiating buyout. We'll see how that all plays out. He's ESPN NBA analyst Jalen Rose. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.